A proposed $9 million bond issue for repairs in the Houston School District failed, as we told you Tuesday night during an election. Well, today, Superintendent Tony Cook talks to us about where they're going from here.
Yeah, our Bobby Martinez also got a firsthand look inside the middle school where there's flooding, leaks, and lighting issues, and those issues continue to get worse. Bobby joins us in the studio with more on this story. Bobby.
Guys, the school board is disappointed with the results, but regardless of Tuesday's outcome of the election, the main focus is to make sure students continue to excel in the classroom.
We're going to still provide our kids a great educational experience.
It is back to the drawing board for Houston Public Schools Superintendent Tony Cook. Cook says he is disappointed with the outcome of the vote against a $9.25 million bond Tuesday.
We put in a lot of work, but you know, my job as superintendent is to identify problems, make the public aware of problems, have a plan to correct it, and then as a district responsibility, it's their job to go out and vote, and the people have spoken.
Cook says that money would have helped repair some of the issues at the schools, issues WCBI had a chance to see firsthand. Inside the Houston Middle School, Principal William Cook walked me through the school to show me some of the leaks inside several classrooms. I saw some of the damage the leaks have caused to the ceiling and lighting in the school.
The roof is leaking bad. We got 23 leaks in this building alone overall, and you know, we keep patching best we can, but they keep more leaks pop up, and you know, the only way to fix them all is by the roofers is to completely redo the roof.
Numerous buckets are placed around the school to catch water leaking from the ceiling. Principal Cook says he wished the voters would have said yes.
I'm disappointed. We have a lot of needs that we need addressed, and you know, these are all things that had to be done, and we got to figure out a way to keep going and get those fixed. But either way, we're going to still have school and still going to educate our kids as best as we can.
Now, with no additional money to address these issues, what is next?
We will continue to patch and do the best we can. I've got a plan to try and get a new roof on the middle school, which is the highest priority right now. That's where we have multiple leaks and multiple issues. So that's our highest priority. And we're moving forward with a plan to try and get that corrected.
Cook says him and the school board will continue to do the best they can to fix these issues. Guys, back to you.